Now, Dan, please give us a sense of just how big our semiconductors and electronics exports are at the moment, and how has this grown in recent years? Is it growing or decreasing?
Over the years, despite the challenges, obviously the pandemic was a huge challenge. But if you look at the CAGR, we're looking at about 5 to 6% growth. So it's growing steadily, modest but steady. The thing is, we're actually exporters. In fact, we're the biggest commodity exporter, accounting for 13% of the country's GDP. Mm-hmm. And with all the technologies, with all the new products and services that's out there, like you said, there's nothing, there's no place to go but up, right? But we were kind of impacted by the pandemic and also by the Russia-Ukraine trade war. A lot of our components come from that that area, not only materials, but also it drove up the cost of power, it disrupted the supply chain. And so, well, and the recession and the high interest rates, all of these impacted the industry. But I think more or less we're seeing some stability, and that's why the industry is projecting recovery in the next two quarters.
And there's also a lot of potential in terms of growing that CAGR. We have a lot of sectors coming in where the semiconductors and electronics industry can even tap into. We're talking about electric vehicles. We're talking about batteries and other technology products that can be made out of this rush for AI worldwide. How do you see the semiconductor and electronics industry playing a role in that?
Well, you know, I was with Secretary Fred Pasquale last month in EU, joined them for three country stops in Belgium, Netherlands, and Germany. And in addition to the technologies that you mentioned, we're also seeing a big interest for, renewable energy companies to move to the Philippines. In fact, next week I'm going to be hosting a visit of one company. This Monday, there was a German company that produces processed gases that was interested in moving big time investments in the Philippines. And so there's hope, there's progress, but of course we're still challenged by the FDIs that are less compared to our neighbors in ASEAN like Vietnam and Thailand. But we're doing the best, and we're leveraging off the technologies that we see. And in fact, you mentioned the big exhibition we're going to have this October from the 25th to 27th at the World Trade Center. This is the second one we're staging after the pandemic. And that too, while it was a modest start after the pandemic, but we're seeing over like 200 booths that are going to be coming in, including exhibitions from China, exhibition partners from China, Taiwan, Singapore. So it's going to be having its international flavor again. It's a three-day event. The first day on the 25th, we'll have our industry track. The second day, we'll have our education track. And the third day will be for the government track. We also have B2B meetings for, those looking for beefing up their supply chain. We're going to have a job fair on the afternoon of the second day. Of course, we've invited the luminaries from government and industry. Including, PESA Director General Teo Panga, DTI Secretary Fred Pasquale, DOLE Secretary Benny, and other luminaries, like I said, including, President Pirso of Bat State U and PASO. So it's going to be a big event, and we're excited to be staging it again. And like I said, we moved it from SMX to World Trade Center. So come one and all.
All right. And that event, of course, is going to be attended to by a lot of stakeholders. That's the 18th Philippine Semiconductor and Electronics Convention and Exhibit. What trends are you seeing? Are there changes in the way you're doing those conventions? And what potentials or maybe new growth areas are you expecting from these gatherings?
Well, for sure, semiconductors will be a big presence there. 70% of our exports are in semiconductors. But the applications, like I said, automotive electronics, including EV, consumer electronics kind of took a dip, but that's recovering as well. But industrial components, communication components, big data. So all of these are going to contribute towards the recovery of the industry. One challenge, as I mentioned, we're going to have a job fair. And one challenge really is plugging the skills gap between what the education institutions produce and what the industry needs. In fact, part of my other role would be as chief of party of what we call the Advanced Manufacturing Work Skills Development. And this is a USAID project in partnership with the Unilab Foundation. And our purpose really is to identify those skills gap that we need from the college graduates to be fully equipped to cope with the industry demands and develop courses for them. We're working with TESDA to develop training regulations for that, consistent with the Philippine Skills Framework and the Philippine Qualifications Framework. So again, the education sector, the education track on date is going to be big. That's the morning plenary session. And then we're going to have a job fair, of course, with representatives from DOLE and TESDA supporting us.
Okay, Dan, lastly, you have a theme for this gathering. It's seeing the Philippine semiconductor and electronics industry into a new industrial revolution. How do you envision that time to be?
Well, you know, as everybody talks about IR 4.0 and getting into IR 4.0, right? But the reality is IR 5.0 is around the corner. And that's why we said the new industrial revolution, because it's not going to stop at 5.0. By the way, the differentiation between 4.0 and 5.0 essentially would be the interface of the human factor versus the automation that you see online. IR 4.0 is pretty big on sensors, Internet of Things, automation, and then you throw in there artificial intelligence and big data. So pretty much we're going to see like closer and closer to a lights out factory. But then again, as we upskill the workforce, that we need to learn how to deal with this new technologies. We need to learn how to deal with automation. And so that's why 4.0 will transition to 5.0 and beyond. That's why we basically term it advanced manufacturing, right? To be a more generalist term.
All right, on that note, Mr. Dan Lachiga of Semiconductors and Electronics Industries in the Philippines Foundation Incorporated. Thank you so much for talking to us today about the state of your industry and your plans for the future. We wish you well.
Thank you very much, Stanley, and good afternoon to your viewers. God bless.